What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today, top three ways to disable pause Windows updates. So let's get right into it. All right, so number one in my list is using an Intune policy. So how will we do this? Now, the first thing that we need to do is log into your Microsoft 365 Admin Center. On the left-hand side, we are going to click on Show All. We're going to locate and click on Endpoint Manager. It's going to load this page up. We're going to click on Devices, and underneath Manage Devices, we're going to click on Configuration. Right here, we're going to click on Create, and it is going to load up a side menu. For the drop-down menu, the first drop-down menu, the platform, we're going to click on it, and we're going to select Windows 10 and later. For the profile type, we're going to click on the drop-down, and we're going to select Settings Catalog, and let's click on Create. Now, let's give our profile a name. This is what I gave it. Let's click on Next. For the configuration settings, I'm going to click on Add Settings. You're going to get a side menu. And for the search box, we are going to type in Pause Updates and click on Search. We're going to select Windows Update for Business. We're going to check off Block Pause Updates, and we're going to exit out of here. Now, we are going to slide it to your right to block it, and we're going to click on Next. For tags, I'm not going to provide a tag, so I'm going to click on Next here. For assignments, I'm going to click on Add Groups, and I'm going to pick my group, which will be Autopilot Devices. I'm going to click Select here. I'm going to click Next. A nice little review, and let's click on Create. And on the upper right-hand side, it should say Policy Created. If you refresh the page, you should see your new policy. Now, number two, it's all about disabling it with a GPO, a Group Policy Object. So let's get into that. So how to do that? I am logged into PC01. I am going to double-click on my Microsoft Management Console, which is a shortcut on the desktop. It is going to load up the user account control. I am going to click yes here. And I already have my group policy management plugin or add-in already hooked up into this section right here. I am going to open up the group policy management. I'm going to open up the forest. I'm going to expand domains, and I'm going to expand my domain. I'm going to expand group policy objects, and I'm going to right-click on that folder, and I'm going to click on new. I'm going to give my new GPO a name, pretty self-explanatory. It is going to hit the computers, and this is the name. Let's click OK. Now, we're going to select our GPO. We're going to right-click on it. We're going to pick Edit. We're going to go inside Computer Configuration. Let's open up Policies. Let's double-click and open up Administrative Templates. From here, let's open up Windows Components, and let's locate Windows Updates. Now, within Windows Updates, we're going to open up Manage In-User Experience, and the one that we need is Remove Access to Pause Update Features. So let's double-click on it. We're going to select Enable. We're going to apply it, and we're going to OK it, and that's it. Now, the third one in my list is using a registry. Pretty simple. So on PC01, I'm going to right-click on the Start menu. I'm going to click on Run. I'm going to type in RegEdit and click OK. I'm going to get the user account control, and I'm going to click Yes. From here, we're going to go into the local machine. Within local machine, let's go inside Software. Within Software, let's go inside Policies. Inside Policies, let's open up Microsoft. And within Microsoft, we're going to open up Windows. Now, within the Windows folder, we're going to locate Windows Updates. And we're going to right-click on that folder, and we're going to go to New, and we're going to create a DWORD 32-bit value. Now, the name for this value would be the following, same way that we see it, and we're going to hit Enter. We're going to double-click on it, and we're going to set it to 1 because 1 is actually going to disable it. 0 is going to enable it. So we're going to OK it, and we're done. How would it look on the other end? So if you open up Settings and go inside Windows Updates, you should see like the pause option should be grayed out. And it says this setting isn't available due to your organizational policy, which is what we want. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.